Welcome to Constructing Minds. The topic for the day is local self-government in rural as well as urban areas. Local self-government is a part of policy of decentralization. Let's understand its meaning. Decentralization is opposite of centralization. Centralization refers to a political structure wherein central government has all the major powers and responsibility. On the other hand, decentralization believes in sharing power and responsibility. That is, central government shares power and responsibility not only with state government but also with the local government in towns, cities and villages. This policy of decentralization became effective only after year 1992. Before 1992, central and state governments were more powerful. Local governments like Panchayat had limited powers and funds to do anything significant in their area. Local government had to depend on central and state governments to take major decisions. And sadly, in most of the cases, the issues of small villages never appeared important to the central government. Luckily, people of India and political leaders realized that decentralization is important in a big and democratic country like India, so that people living in small and remote villages or town also get a voice. There are a large number of problems and issues which are best known and settled at the local level. For example, the need of a water tank in a village can be very important for the people of that village, and their leaders in Panchayat can take a quick decision. But that need of a water tank may not look significant to the central government, which has major issues at the national and international level to deal with. For this reason, at the local level, people should be made aware and responsible to manage the problems in their localities and effectively use funds and resources to solve them. This way, people can directly participate in decision making. And that's where we achieve democracy by ensuring the rule of the common people. Only a few ministers of the central government should not have power. The panchayat leaders in small villages, councillors in cities should also get power and resources to ensure welfare of the common people. With these objectives, an amendment or change in the Indian constitution was introduced in the year 1992. Let's look at the changes. It is mandatory to hold regular elections to local government bodies. State Election Commission of each state has the responsibility to conduct local level elections, that is, panchayat and municipal elections. To ensure the participation of every section of society, seats are reserved for SCs, STs and OBCs. Besides, 1/3 seats are reserved for women. To make local government resourceful, the state governments are required to share some powers and revenue with local government bodies, and panchayat and municipalities can spend that revenue for the development of villages, towns or cities. Now let's understand the local administration in villages, which is termed as panchayati raj. Gram panchayat is a decision-making body in a village. Panchayat is a council consisting of several ward members or panch and a president or sarpanch. Let's see who are these ward members. For the purpose of election, a village is divided into smaller areas known as ward. Size of a ward depends on the population. One ward member is elected from each ward. Now, the question is, who elects the panchayat leaders? The answer is Gram Sabha, which is a group of all the adult people in a village who are 18 years of age or above. The Gram Sabha plays a significant role in a village. It supervises the work of Panchayat and keeps a check on Panchayat's work in the village. The annual budget of the Gram Panchayat is approved by Gram Sabha. The performance of Gram Panchayat is reviewed by Gram Sabha. And for all these activities and responsibilities, Gram Sabha has to meet at least twice or thrice in a year. Thus, here we see that local self-government helps the common people to directly participate in ensuring a better administration in their locality. Let's proceed ahead to understand the structure of Panchayati Raj system. After Gram Panchayat, the next level is Panchayat Samiti. If you observe it carefully, you may understand that Panchayat Samiti is a group of a few Gram Panchayats. Panchayat Samiti is also known as Block Samiti or Mandal. The members of this representative body are elected by all the Panchayat members in that area. The next level is Zila Parishad. Zila is district, and Zila Parishad is a group of all the Panchayat Samitis in a district. Most of the Zila Parishad members are elected. Members of the Lok Sabha and MLAs of that district and some other officials of other district level bodies are also its members. The Zila Parishad is headed by Zila Parishad Chairperson. Like in villages, in urban areas also we have a clear structure of local government. Let's divide the urban areas into small towns and big cities. Like panchayats in villages, we have municipalities in towns and municipal corporations in cities. Both municipalities and municipal corporations are run by elected bodies. You must have heard of municipal elections in your area. Municipality is headed by municipal chairperson. And municipal corporation is headed by mayor. So this was all about local self-government in rural and urban areas. The structure of local government helps common people to directly participate in the governance. It's easier for common people to take their day-to-day problems to councillor or panchayat, rather than to the Chief Minister or Prime Minister. Thank you for watching this video. Please like, share and comment. Do not forget to subscribe to Constructing Minds.